Griffiths, Mr. Judy Dean, Madam Mayor, consort, Governor, staff, pupils, guests. Good evening and welcome, and thanks for coming along to this important event in the school calendar. You're going to hear so much about the great things that have been happening over the last year. And in fact, I'm sure it's going to be one of those occasions when we will all leave at the end of the evening with a feeling of immense pride in this remarkable school and its talented students. A great start for the beginning of the new school year. But first, I'd like to congratulate those of you who will be receiving awards this evening. They're well deserved, and you have excelled in a school of high achievers. That in itself is pretty tough and makes the achievement even greater. We're very, very proud of you. I also wish to thank and recognise our highly talented and dedicated staff, led by an outstanding headmistress, who all work so very hard to assist and encourage our students to maximise their potential. And also to you, the parents, who provide the vital domestic and emotional support so often necessary in this increasingly competitive world. To you all, a very big thank you. I should like to take this opportunity of congratulating Ms. Hinks on the leadership she is giving to the girls' schools throughout the country, and more broadly, the independent school sector, in this her year as President of the Girls' Schools Association. This is a prestigious appointment, and in this capacity, she represents the heads of independent girls' schools throughout the whole of the UK. I give a very warm welcome to Mr. Julie Dean, an old girl of the school. I'm delighted that the headmistress has invited you to present the prizes this evening. We are really fortunate here in the girls' division to enjoy great support from very many old girls, and it is really much appreciated. It exposes the present generation of pupils to the first-hand experience of a great many of their predecessors, who have followed a multitude of interesting and varied careers. It's worth noting that over 2,000 former students of both divisions have offered to help with careers advice. That's a remarkable testimony to the high regard in which this school is held by its alumni. This continuing support by alumni is a very important aspect of the ethos of Bolton School, and one of the many things that makes this place so special, and has done so for very many years. I personally remember when I myself was a pupil here over 50 years, being given careers advice at an industrial location away from the school by old boys of the school. Somehow, it was particularly refreshing to be given advice by people I did not know, but who were freely willing to give their time, help, and to share their experience. Bolton School is thriving. You can detect the buzz, the enthusiasm, the vigour whenever you visit. Demand for places is strong, and our finances are in robust shape. This is a confident school, but I hope too that we're not complacent. We live in challenging times, full of exciting opportunities, and with plenty of hazards still to negotiate. This year has again been very successful, and no doubt soon you will hear far more of that from the headmistress in her report. But I should like to congratulate the school on being named as the TES Independent School of the Year. This is perhaps the most highly prestigious award of its kind in the country, and recognises on a national scale the outstanding features of this school. The judges made it clear that what makes this school really stand out, apart from its many outstanding and extracurricular achievements, is the important role it plays in the community, and how we endeavour to provide an education for all through our generous bursary scheme. They had clearly identified our real ethos and the values that we hold so dear in ensuring that our students have an outstanding all-round education. And whilst we're talking about awards and bursaries, I was delighted at the school's great efforts in raising £5 million for our bursary fund through the 100 campaign, was also recognised nationally by being claimed the fundraising campaign of the year. The provision of bursaries is an important strand of our strategy to make the school accessible and affordable to all, irrespective of their financial or social background. Another equally important strand is to ensure that fee increases are kept to a minimum without impairing the outstanding education that we provide. This year we have, for the fourth year running, kept our fee increases to a level significantly below the national average and significantly below that of most other schools in the north of England. It has been quite a challenging thing to achieve, particularly in a year when the education sector has suffered from some quite exceptional cost increases. And I pay tribute to our colleagues who continue to discover efficiencies whilst at the same time improving our offering. This evening I should also like to express my sincere thanks and pay tribute to three distinguished governors who together have given 35 years voluntary service to this foundation and who retired from the governing body last December. It is actually worth remembering that the governors are responsible for developing the overall strategy of the foundation and ensuring its execution. These three have done us proud over many years. Caroline Topham served on many committees and was the designated governor for the early years foundation stage. Roger Gould chaired the consultative committee and held the key appointment of executive governor. Tony Aldershaw successfully guided us through this complex building program that we have completed over the last 12 years. We were extremely fortunate and had someone with his vast expertise and huge commitment throughout this time. As many of you already know, I will also be retiring from the governing body this December after 33 years. And so this is my last presentation to you as Chairman of Governors. My first connection with this school was 61 years ago, in September 1958, when I started, age 11, as a new boy in the boys' division. Things were quite different in those days. For example, there was no school post service. My own journey from rural Lancashire was a combination of bicycles, steam train, smoke-filled double-decker bus before being deposited outside the Central Arch. Another huge difference was the lack of contact between pupils of both divisions. In fact, it was positively discouraged. It almost seemed as if we had our own virtual Berlin Wall down the middle of what was then known as the Central Quad, dividing both schools. I recall hearing about a member of the girls' division being disciplined. She was being disciplined for having been seen walking along Jolly New Road. Yes, she was accompanied by a member of the boys' division. When called before the authorities to explain this misdemeanor, she explained that it was her twin brother, and they were simply walking home together from school. How things have changed. In those days too, the north wing that adjoins Jolly New Road had not yet been built, and the campus as envisioned by Lord Leavingham when he re-endowed the school over 100 years ago was still to be completed. The Lord Leavingham, the Leavingham connection though, was still strong. His grandson, the third Viscount, was Chairman of Governors. He was still the Chairman of Governors in 1986 when I was invited to join the governing body. In the years that followed, several new buildings were added to the campus. And in the last 12 years, the programme has accelerated with the building of a new beach house, Hesketh House, and Moriah Centre. And so we can consider, after 100 years, that the campus has been completed. But schools are not just about buildings and material assets. Arguably, the far more important aspects of a school are the people and the teachers, the ethos and the values that guide the school. I believe that these are fundamentally the same today as when I first arrived over 60 years ago. For that, we must thank a generation of teachers, led by inspirational heads, who have guided us and continue to do so. And perhaps it's also interesting to reflect that over that 60 years, there have only been 5 headmistresses and 4 chairmen of governors, and it has been my great privilege to have known and worked with them all. It has been a huge privilege and honour to serve this great school as a governor and as chairman for the last 12 years. My successor is an alumnus of the school, Mr. Ian Ryan, who has had a distinguished career in private equity. He and I have worked very closely as governors over the last 5 years, and particularly over the last 9 months. And we are very fortunate to have a man of his distinction to become our next chairman. Supported by a board of governors of outstanding ability and dedication. We have a clear understanding of the ethos of Bolton School and the nature of the education that it should deliver. We believe strongly in independence so that we can deliver without government financial constraints and interference the type of education most appropriate for the young people in our charge. To achieve that, we must remain financially strong. We believe in accessibility and affordability, so that all those who are able have the freedom to benefit from a Bolton School education. We believe in delivering a quality education, not just academically, that's a given, but in the breadth of extracurricular activities that can deliver a broad, rounded education and produce confident young women who, when they leave this place, are well equipped to go out in the world and make a difference for good. And now, to those of you who have just left school at the end of last year, and for whom today will be the last time that you will be in this great hall as a pupil, almost a pupil, I hope it will not be the last time that you visit the school, because we pride ourselves on being a lifetime community. And you are, and will always remain, part of that community. And you will always be assured of a very warm welcome. We are all extremely proud of your achievements, and we're immensely proud to be associated with you. So good luck. Follow your instincts, but above all, keep to the values you have learned here. They are precious. Youth brings vitality and energy, and an ability to look at things totally differently, without years of prejudice in your baggage. Someone once said that the young don't know enough to be prudent, and therefore they attempt the impossible and achieve it generation after generation. How true that is. One thing I would ask is that in whatever you do, try to make a difference for good. How satisfying if when you travel through life, you make each place a tiny bit better than when you arrive. You are the future, and it's your future, so good luck. But don't forget, have lots of fun along the way. Thank you.